Supervision is now in session. The Honorable Judge Bryce Morley presiding.
No, we don't.
Everyone but the jury may be seated. Commissioner Lawrence, please swear in the jury.
Please raise your right hand. Do you solemnly swear to affirm that you will truly listen to this case and render a true verdict and a fair sentence as to this defendant? You may be seated.
Members of the jury, your duty today will be determining whether the defendant is guilty or not guilty based only on facts and evidence provided in this case. Prosecution has the burden of proving the guilt of the defendant beyond a reasonable doubt. This burden remains on the prosecution through the trial. The prosecution must prove that a crime was committed and that the defendant is the person who committed the crime. However, if you are not satisfied of the defendant's guilt to that extent, the reasonable doubt exists and the defendant must be found not guilty. Mr. Leonards, what is today's case?
Your Honor, today's case is the State of New Columbia versus Chris Hunter.
Is the prosecution ready?
Yes, Your Honor.
Is the defense ready?
Yes.
You're awesome.
Oh, okay, yes.
All right. Any statements?
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, Milan Jackson is dead. This is an undisputed fact of the case. What is disputed, however, is how Mrs. Johnson died. Did she fall from the clock tower during her task as a pledge? Which would be hazing. Or did she climb up there and fall on her own account on accident? Or was she pushed on account of murder? Regardless of whatever the stories the defense may make up, we are here to prove beyond a reasonable doubt that Chris Archer murdered and hazed Milan Jackson. Thank you.
If a mother tells her daughter to run to town, get groceries, and the daughter gets into a wreck and dies, is the mother responsible for her death? Should she be charged with first-degree murder? That is what the prosecution is saying, that Chris Archer should be charged with the first-degree murder, which states intended to kill. He did not intend for her to kill or to die. He intended for her to raise the flag so she can be a gamma. Thank you.
Prosecution, you may call your first witness. Will the witness please stand and be sworn in by the bailiff?
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth to help you, God?
Alex, tell us about your relationship with Milan.
It was good. She came.
Time out. Jury, do you have any idea who this is?
No.
Maybe that would be a good idea. Prosecution. Prosecution and defense too. You need to introduce your witnesses. The prosecution calls, blah, 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 blah.
What?
Introduce your witness. Nobody knows who this is.
This is Alex Richard.
Talk to them.
This is Alex Richard. She's a psychiatrist.
Okay.
How did Milan describe her time during a week?
My My mother said that it was really difficult for her. She already developed a strong sense of loyalty to the parents.
Did my lawn hear any fears of phobias?
She had mentioned her fear of heights to me in our other session. This is because her favorite aunt Tanya committed suicide from a high ledge. I cannot imagine Myla ever going to that ledge without being pressured into it.
Was she intoxicated?
Yes, she had. When she died, she had a blood alcohol content that was 0.0.
Would this lessen her fear of heights?
No, Myla was a frequent drinker, so I am unsure that her tolerance level would affect the alcohol would have.
The defense may cross-examine the witness.
Never mind. Is he doing all your cross-examination?
Yeah,
yeah, and he has
I can see if I can get the most questions.
Mr.
I can text
DJ,
Jason.
Can somebody text him for the questions?
Yeah, text him, see if you can get the questions.
Call on Ari.
Please excuse the interruption. At this time, email should be now working. Email should be now working. Thank you.
I gotta go.
You can't just walk out on the jury.
You just did.
Your court case isn't even.
Hey,
we're
trying
to
figure
this out.
Yeah,
he's farming.
He's really bad voice.
Did somebody text him?
Yeah, I really did.
Just call him.
Yeah, you should just call him.
Yeah.
So he's got the cross examination questions for
every single person.
Yeah.
Why am I? This is one thing.
Because that's how we did it.
We didn't think Jason.
I have
no clue. Yeah, you guys have no idea. That happens every single day.
All right, here's what we're going to do. They're going to keep calling witnesses. You guys see what you can come up with for cross-examination. We'll have a chance to call them back up, though.
Okay.
All right, but we're going to use the time to get the witnesses in.
Okay.
Okay.
Uses
calling
Tyler Johnson the same.
Yes.
All right, Tyler, why don't you tell the jury what you are at Columbia University?
Right now I'm the co-captain of the Gamma. I've been head since freshman, and this year Chris actually took over as the head. I was disappointed because I thought we had a better friendship.
Do you recall the events of Saturday, November 22nd?
Yes.
Adam Milan's death?
Yes.
What events led to Milan running up the clock tower?
Chris had mentioned something about a plan that he refused to tell me. And he refused to tell anyone. And I knew it was something skeptical because usually Chris will tell me everything because we plan all the events out. And we would. No one was told anything until the night of the incident.
Okay, that's interesting. What was your relationship with Milan?
Milan, me and her are really good friends. Kind of connected right off the bat. First week, we typically hung out after class or whatever.
What was your first impression of Milan?
My first impression of Milan was she was very common, like me, we had things in common.
What do you think was Chris Archer's opinion of Milan?
Chris Archer liked her at first, but after he got to know her a little bit more, he tried to set her up with her, with his friend, and she turned it down, and then kind of hatred formed towards her.
All right. What sort of pledging activities, if any, occurred on November 17th?
I did not recall.
What did you see at the clock tower the night Milan died?
No one could really see anything. Chris and Milan were ahead of us, and we were too far back to see anything. By the time we got there, Milan was already on the ground bleeding out.
No more questions, Your Honor.
You can sit down.
We're getting locked
in. Prosecution, you may call your next witness.
Prosecution calls Pat Smith to the stand. Pat, how long have you known Miley for, and tell me how your relationship with her was?
I've been best friends since third grade. She was in Yale High School, and I introduced myself to her because we both got into fun a lot. The boys were best friends, and then we decided to go to the same colleges together, so we've grown up together.
Did you two attend college after high school? Tell me a little bit about that and where you guys attended.
Yes, we went to a university in New Columbia together. We decided to enroll, and we knew that that was a good school for parties, and we both had good academics.
Did you join any fraternities or sororities in college, and what were they like?
I object. Leaving.
If you want, ask him to repeat the question.
Did you join any fraternities or sororities in college, and what were they like?
Overruled.
That means you can go on with the question, and you can answer it.
It's not a good question.
We decided to get around more, so we looked around and we saw the fraternity. We asked around, and everybody seemed very welcoming and such, so we decided that we wanted to try it.
So then what events led up to Mylan's death from your perspective?
She's already sworn in.
So I don't have to do it.
Yep.
Okay. You knew that it was a big party at school when you enrolled to New Columbia. You were looking forward to the parties and to being part of a fraternity.
Yeah.
Why did you want to be a gamma? Did you know what it would be, would have to take to get in, and think about your... pleading gamma.
Whatever me and Mylan were looking into it, they all seemed really welcoming and such. My parents were both into the gamma fraternity, and they made it sound like the time of their lives. And Mylan's favorite aunt was also in it, and she absolutely loved it, and she was the head of it. So we had no idea what we were getting into. We just knew that everybody we knew enjoyed it.
With gamma high popularity and powerful influence, Were you willing to anything it took to get to be a gamma?
We thought so.
Gammas have high requirements, and say you were willing to do anything but keep going because you wanted to be gamma. You could have just quit any time and leave, but no, you stayed. Why?
I don't really know. I just knew it after everything happened, and they let me come back after I lied to the police. They let me, and I continued to do it.
That's all.
I can't
believe his freaking handwriting. All right, you do it next time.
So, are you ready to cross any of the other witnesses?
Yeah.
Tyler Johnson. Who's that? Person?
Yeah, this person.
Okay.
You read the handwriting?
You read it. I can't read his handwriting.
You already sworn
it. Why would you be mad at Chris if he was elected and not you?
Because we had a friendship for a majority of our college.
What you said could have been out of hate and unbiased perspective on what really happened.
That's all that me and Chris have been through in planning all the game events, but all of our college life would not turn on Chris for one decision.
If you didn't have a drinking problem, could you have saved her from falling off the ledge, or were you too busy getting drunk?
Truthfully, too busy getting drunk because none of us had known what Chris had planned. If we were aware of it, we had more of a likability to prevent the accident happening. You think?
And prosecution, you're allowed to recall witnesses too.
If you're really concerned with her and the gammas, you would talk to the dean, and despite what she said.
I did talk to the dean, but he blew it off several times.
She was afraid of heights, and you said she climbed to the clock tower to prove herself. Why would she do something she was scared of and do it anyway?
She was so devoted to the gammas.
Why would Chris Archer be intimidated of Mylan, the freshman, based on what Pat said? He would outcast her. Wouldn't it make any sense to kill her? And being there for everyone to see doesn't make a good story.
I'm not really sure why.
That's all questions.
Defense, you can call your first witness.
Well, that's does the prosecution want to recall any of their witnesses? You got anything you want to clear up? Okay.
Call your first witness.
We'll do one, and then I want to say some things before we get done.
John, you're going first?
being Jesse Thomas to his fam. When was the last report of Hayden?
Approximately 5 years ago.
Do you know Chris Archer personally?
Yes, he came and helped organize an anti-hazing organization.
Did any pledges come to you about being put in any physical danger?
Yes, Pat Smith came to me and told me that there was hazing activities with Phi Gamma, but then she told the police that this never happened, so I couldn't organize a file report.
That's all the questions.
No, 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 no. Is
So Dr. Jordan, you have a PhD in American history and is the local historian, right?
Correct.
In one of your books, in the Mist of Writing, you claim that Phi Gammas have a very sinister side to them. Is this correct?
I do not recall.
You stated that the Gammas were known for the dangerous hazing techniques dating all the way back to 1955. Unexplained injuries and deaths have occurred on campus during pledging, starting in the 1960s and 70s. Raising the flag tradition started, requiring a pledge to climb after a lot of consumption of alcohol. Does this seem familiar?
Yes, it does.
You also said that after injuries and deaths, most clubs around the nation settled down on hazing, but Phi Gammas was no exception to this trend. Do you agree with this?
Yes.
There were five more hazing incidents reported since 1987, and yet nothing has done about this. Is this report accurate?
Yes, it was.
So why are you here to defend the murder of Mylon Jackson when the president of the club should have known that the previous incidents of the deaths of when people fell
before
and go make someone hanging the flag knowingly that there is drinking involved? Yeah.
Because there has been no known occurrence of this act since 1978, so they don't know why she was up there.
We would like to call Chris Archer up to the stand.
Please raise your right hand. Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and the truth, and the truth, and the truth?
What kind of attitude did Mylon have?
She was really kind to the officers, but she was really rude to everyone else. That was in the campus.
What position do you have with the fraternity?
I'm the president.
How did the other members feel about Mylon?
It's not that we didn't like her, we just didn't like her attitude at times.
What kind of things did pledges have to do during Hell Week?
We made them like clean the bathrooms with the toothbrushes, that kind of thing. Like, we never pushed them to.
Are you concerned with what you have the pledges do, hazing? What did Pat Smith go to the hospital for?
Well, when we saw her, she was sitting in a corner and she didn't speak up to anyone, but she had an asthma attack apparently.
What was the last task you had Mylon do?
I asked her to raise the flag in front of the Gamma House, but she ran to the clock tower.
No more questions.
I'm filling for John today.
Okay.
Chris, can you recall the events the night of Saturday, November 22nd?
Yes. Well, when I first met her, I told her that, like, I was joking around, and I said, if you really want to impress us, you will do something so great that the campus will hang the Gamma flag from the clock tower. Joking. But I whispered to her, you're gonna have to raise the flag. But I didn't mean in front of the bell tower. She had been drinking, I had been drinking, we all had. But I didn't push her to. No one forced anyone to drink.
How do you feel about hazing? Because obviously that was involved.
I don't agree with it. There's a lot of anti-hazing rules and laws. So I never haze anyone because of the consequences.
So how did you overall feel about Mylon?
I liked her at times. I didn't like her attitude though.
So when she died, she was involved in what is called Hell Week. Can you go and kind of explain what that is?
Yeah, it's just like pranks. And we just pretty much make the pledges do things as a joke, though. We never haze them. We don't touch them and we don't encourage them to drink. Reckless pledges get.
Was Hell Week a task that was assigned for Mylon?
Yeah.
What kind, if any, hazing activities happened on the night of November 22nd?
That night we asked her to hang the flag in front of the house.
Good. Thank you.
Next up.
Now either side can recall any of their witnesses. If one side recalls the witness, the other side can cross, just like before. And if neither side wants to recall, then we can go on to closing statements.
I would like to call Dean Jesse Thomas in this case. Is hazing allowed on campus?
No.
So when Pat Smith came to you with hazing, why didn't you take further action?
Because she told the police that she was lying. That never happened.
When there were reports of hazing, why didn't you look into it?
Because if she told the police that that didn't happen, I'm not allowed to start an investigation.
No further questions.
I'd like to call Pat Smith. Why did you want to be a gamer?
My parents were both gamers, and they really enjoyed it. They said it was the time of their lives in college.
Did you know what it would have taken to become a gamer, and did you think about the consequences while pledging for a gamer?
Whenever I knew about the gamers, I wasn't told about anything awful that they would have made us do, such as like when they forced us to drink and stuff.
But you were aware of the consequences that could have followed with the truck drinking. With gamma's high popularity and a powerful influence, you said you are willing to do anything, such as drinking and perhaps even violating climbing the clock tower. Would you have done anything like that? After all, you did say you're willing to do anything to become a gamma.
I wasn't willing to risk my life for it.
Gamma's also have high requirements. And you said you're willing to do anything. You repeated that. But you kept going and you wanted to become a gamer. After you had your asthma attack, they invited you back and you became because you wanted to become a gamer, correct? So why did you go? Well, after your near-death experience with your asthma attack, you selfishly went back. You stated that if you would have quit, Mylon would have quit it too. So if you would have quit, she would have quit and she would still be alive. But it was your selfish acts that caused her to die. So that's on you. I also like to call Alex Richards to the stand. I like to call Tyler Johnson to the stand. Are you mad at Chris Archer?
I'm mad at his decisions and what he had made.
Or are you mad at him that he got the president's spot and you got the vice president?
I felt betrayed, but I wouldn't say I was upset.
But you said you were mad at him because he was elected and not you. You felt betrayed. You said that. But you think you've been, but do you think your hatred towards him has become making an unbiased judgment call on what you believe? Are you perhaps lying that you could get Chris Archer in trouble so he'll face jail time and you become the next president of Gamma so you can fulfill your destiny to become the next president where you so always wanted?
I was upset, yeah, but I would never turn on my friend like that.
But you were willing to lie for him to go to jail so you could be called the spot president. Were you willing to lie on this about Chris Archer and what his acts did so you become the next president of Gamma?
No.
But you said you felt betrayed, the hatred. Everything, your perspective changed about him ever since he became president because you felt betrayed and that hatred built and made him and it made you make him hate him more and more. So you're telling me you would never lie on this. but you always wanted to be the president, and you said you'd do anything it will take to become president. Would that include lying?
I wouldn't do anything I could, but if I were to get that presidency, I would make the game a better. But Chris won't appear in square.
But yeah, you felt betrayed. You felt hatred towards him. After all, he was the one elected.
That's true.
So why'd you feel hatred and betrayed by him if he wasn't the one, if he was elected by the people?
Because I became head my freshman year, and we've been friends all along. Whenever it's coming up to the big moment, he's kind of stole that shine away from me.
But it wasn't his choice to be president. He was elected there by himself. He was, the people elected him. The people of Gamble elected him to become president, not you. And your drinking problem that has been going on ever since you're out of college, has that played a role in my mom's death?
No.
So you're telling me that you, when you told her you should do something spectacular, something that would make the campus know you, and when he said hang the flag, you think she went back on your advice to do something spectacular, to do something outrageous like climb the clock tower, when after all Chris Archer wanted to do was hang out in the Gala House? But no, she went on back on your advice and went to the clock tower where she fell to her death because on you.
No, because we were not informed about what all had been said. Chris had pulled Milan off to the side one night, and we had nothing to hear about it, and Chris refused to tell any of us.
But you told her previously, days before, that if she wanted to become a gala, she had to do something spectacular. And when Chris told her to hang the flag, do you honestly believe that she went back on your advice on to do something spectacular to become a gala, like climbing the clock tower?
Milan was dedicated, but I don't think she'd be that dedicated to come back on my.
She faced her fear of heights, apparently. So would she go back on your, would she go back on your advice to do what she could do to become a gamer?
Just because you overcome your fear don't mean that you're going to go out of your way.
She comes and she died because on your advice, what you told her to do.
I had told her that she should do something spectacular.
And she took that advice and she fell off the clock tower where she died. Were you concerned about Milan's health before this?
Yes.
If you're really concerned about the gamos, would you tell the dean?
I tried to talk to him several times, but he minimized problems.
So, even though it was a problem, you still wouldn't go to him because?
I did go to him, but he minimized the problem, so I couldn't.
Then why'd you bring it to higher authorities? But that was really a problem. Next, why would Chris Archer, you said Chris Archer was almost intimidated on Wyman. Why would he be intimidated on her?
Yeah, she felt so comfortable with the game already and started making more friends and thought he might be a threat to them.
But he was the president of the highest fraternity on campus. She was a freshman. He could have the power just to have her outcasted, but yeah, he supposedly he killed her. It just doesn't make any sense. They kill a small problem like that.
Any more recalls?
Nope.
Everyone ready for closing statements?
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, all I ask of you today is to make the right choice to give justice to this man so that future generations coming will not experience any of this hazing and nonsense that can lead to murder like this one and others before it as well. So that another mother and father don't have to bury their child at such a young age over just trying to get accepted into a club.
Vince, your closing statements.
So should Chris Archer be charged with first-degree murder, even though Chris Archer did not even push Milan or even touch her in any way? When Milan was trying to hang the flag for everyone to see, but then Milan stumbled and Chris Archer was trying to grab her shoulder, but it was too late and she fell to her death.
jury. You've heard all of the testimonies concerning this case. It is now up to you to determine the facts. You and you alone are the judges of the fact. Once you decide what facts the evidence proves, you must then apply the law as I give it to you to the facts as you want.
Okay, let's go deliberate. That means me.
Have you reached a verdict?
Yes.
What say you?
Okay. Can I just say it? All right. We the jury find Chris Archer guilty of criminal hazing, and we the jury find Chris Archer guilty of manslaughter.
Crap. Thank you, jury, for your service today. Court is adjourned.
Good jury. Please stand and be sworn in by the bailiff.
Raise your right hand. You promise to say the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth.
Yep.
Mr. Johnson, is Chris Archer known to be violent?
Chris let things get out of hand, and he let the male gamblers hit the pledges on the backside with a wooden paddle.
What did Chris Archer think about violence?
Chris did not lie for attitude. Chris said that Hell Knight will give Melina a permanent attitude change.
During the night of Hell Knight, what was Chris's plan to do with Melina?
He never mentioned his plans again until it was the night of Melina's death, but then it was too late.
No farther questions, Your Honor.
The defense may cross-examine the witness.
Open all that question.
Don't want to cross-examine their witness.
We don't have any questions.
I guess they call the next witness.
We wish him down.
Thank you.
Prosecution calls Dr. Richards to the phone.
Will the witness please stand and be sworn in by the bailiff?
Say the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth.
Dr. Richards, what is your position on this university?
I'm a psychiatrist and student counselor, and Columbus University is a safe place.
In what manner did you know Mom Jackson?
She was a student that came to me for counseling.
Did Mom mention any therapists?
Yes. She said she had been afraid of heights ever since the incident with her aunt.
So in your professional opinion, would my mom willingly go to the top of the clock tower?
No, in my professional opinion, she did not.
No other questions, Your Honor.
The defense may cross-examine the witness.
What kind of students come for you for counseling?
Lower everybody, they just come.
Prosecution, you may call your next witness.
I only have three witnesses.
Do you want to recall any?
Defense, you may call your first witness.
Call her. Chris.
Chris Archer to stand.
Will the witness please stand and be sworn in by the bench?
Please raise your right hand. If you promise to say the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth.
Chris, tell me what happened on the night of November 22nd.
Well, we were at the five-game Greek fraternity.
Was Mylan drinking alcohol that night?
Yeah, Luke, she was drinking alcohol. We all had some alcohol. We were drinking.
Did you try to stop Mylan from jumping?
Yes, I did. I tried to reach out and grab her as she was jumping.
Did you think her death was accidental?
Objection, Your Honor.
Leading. Sustain.
No further questions, Your Honor.
Prosecution may cross-examine the witness.
Mr. Archer, you are the president of Phi Gamma, correct?
Yes.
So basically, you run all activities, such as pledge activities?
Yes.
So you knew about the campus hazing policy?
Yes, I did.
Approach the witness, Your Honor. Could you read this policy to the jury?
This memo is a reminder to call Columbus University students that hazing is a violation of campus policy and a crime. We will suspend any fraternity, sororities, or any other organizations that haze their potential members. In addition, if we find any student has hazed another student, that student will be brought before the campus tribunal.
So, Mr. Archer, does this statement from past minutes sound like something you could have done? And I quote Mrs. Smith here, "Very bad, they made us do harsh things, such as we were forced to eat dirt, drink large quantities of alcohol, clean toilets with our toothbrushes, and many other harsh things." None of that was made by the pledge activities. Mr. Archer, you are in the court of law. So I believe you're lying because another quoted statement from Tyler Johnson says, "Chris let things get out of hand and the male gammas hit the pledges on the backside with a wooden paddle." Does this sound familiar, Mr. Archer?
It's not true.
It's not true. Once again, you are in the court of law, Mr. Archer. I have several more questions. Mr. Archer, on the last night of Hell Week, why did you follow Mylan up the clock tower if she was just hanging a flag?
Because I saw her reaching out to grab the flag, and it looked like she was going to slip, so I went out there.
Well, why'd you follow her up the clock tower?
Because I saw her going up there before, and I knew she was drunk, so I was going to.
But isn't she scared of heights?
I think so.
And why would she go up the clock tower?
Because I was just wondering what she was doing, because I didn't want her up there by herself.
So did you happen to put your hand on her shoulder? Because according to Pat Smith, you shoved Mylan off the ledge using your hand directly to her shoulder. Do you feel content with yourself after that? No further questions, Your Honor.
The defense, you may call your second one.
Call where?
Please stand to be sworn in by the mayor.
Please raise your right hand. Promise to say the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth.
What did you know about Tanya Mock?
She was my land's aunt, and she died by committing suicide by jumping off the building, which is how Tanya died, which could be related to how why she jumped off the building. She was the president of Phi Gamma, and she was very popular in college.
Did you pay Pat Smith to give you information?
Yeah, I paid Pat Smith $1,000 to give me information about the case.
No further questions.
The prosecution may cross-examine the witness.
Mr. Jordan Mitchell, were you at the clock tower at the time of Melanie's death?
No.
If you were not at the clock tower, who was all up at the top.
Chris and I like that.
If you know this, how weren't you a witness?
I don't.
No part of the question.
Fans, you may call your next witness.
Dean.
Will the witness please stand this morning on my behalf?
Your Honor, you promise to say the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. Hey.
Dean, how do you know Chris Hunter?
I know Chris personally. He is accredited to the university and the president of the Gammas. He volunteers a lot at the school and has a huge leadership campus. And he publicly denounced hazing of any kind at a bank or like that.
Do you ever have any disciplinary action against your faculty?
We've had some disciplinary actions against other fraternities, even though we have a strict enforcement campus rules about hazing.
Prosecution may call the name of the witness.
Mr. Thomas, is hazing allowed on Columbus University?
No.
So, just to be clear, there is no hazing on campus?
There is some, but we have strict rules about it.
So when Pat Smith came to you with a report of hazing, why did you not take further action? Is there a history of hazing reports being changed throughout the past?
The Gammas have not had any reports over the past couple of years.
So when these reports were changed, why did you not look into them?
Say is not evidence. However, do not listen closely. They are intended to aid you in understanding the case. Prosecution, you may begin.
Thank you, Your Honor. Members of the jury,
Time out. I want to make sure that none of us want to recall any witnesses before we're ready for closing arguments. This went awfully fast. Faster than I think it should have gone. So I think we'd be. I'll give you a chance to recall people here to think about it.
Members of the jury, today you have heard a testimony about Chris Archer dealing with first degree murder and criminal hazing. And I would like to remind you some of the important information that you should consider in your decision. These facts include that Mr. Archer has clearly hazed others and committed a first-degree murder by shoving Mylan off the edge when we have had a clear witness in the case. He has also been involved in and led his group to haze others throughout Phi Gamma's years. Please find the defendant guilty of the charge of first-degree murder and criminal hazing. Thank you.
Defense, you may proceed with your closing argument.
Thank you, Your Honor. Members of the jury, today you have heard a testimony about Chris Archer. I would like to remind you of important information that should be considered in your decision. These facts include that Mylan was drunk at the time of the incident, and she was going up the clock tower to raise the flag because she was dedicated to getting into the Phi Gamma fraternity. Please find our client not guilty. Thank you.
Members of the jury, you have heard all the testimony concerning this case. It is now up to you to determine the facts. You and you alone are the judges of the fact. Once you decide what facts the evidence proves, you must then apply the law as I give it to you, the facts as you find out.
I'm going to take them in the hallway where we can deliberate quick.
How do you turn this thing off?
Have you reached a verdict?
We have. We find Chris Archer guilty of criminal hazing and manslaughter.
Thank you, jury. For your service today, court is adjourned. Okay. Guilty on.
Like how we, you know, when they were saying about how they made him drink alcohol and eat dirt, and, you know, they were saying they were paddling him, and then they made him do like one big initiation, which was what Milan had intended to do with Clement Cocktail.
Okay. How about the manslaughter? Why, in your minds, why didn't you give the prosecution, like you guys said you felt like the prosecution won. Why didn't you give the prosecution first degree murder?
I would say because she was willingly a part of the whole thing. You know, she wasn't forced into it. But I would say manslaughter because, you know, it was Chris Archer's whole thing to put them in sketchy situations.
Okay. So to have first degree murder, you need what? What's that?
It's planned.
It's planned. Premeditation. So did you guys feel like the prosecution proved premeditation?
No.
Okay. There's an area where we could have.
I felt like they showed that they were at, like Chris Archer maybe was at fault a little bit, and that they had like a sort of like they clashed, but I don't think they proved that there was like hard set connected.
Okay. How about, that he physically pushed her? That he's responsible for the killing himself. Do you feel like that was? Did they prove that to you guys or not? Okay. So in your minds, there was a doubt there. It could have been a slip. He could have been trying to.
They really didn't even mention it. So.
Well, I think.
It wasn't
hammered on, but they did bring it up. And it might have actually been brought up by the defense, saying that he was trying to stop her from falling.
But then, like, why was she up there in the first place?
That they asked that. I think you guys asked that exact question, right? Why follow her up? And Kurt said, well, if she was drunk, I was worried that she was going to fall off. Okay. So now second degree murder would be no premeditation, but intent to kill. You don't feel like there was intent to kill either.
I feel like they just left like a doubt when it came to the whole whether he tried to grab her, whether he pushed her. It wasn't like definitive enough. We just knew that they were both up there, and then she, you know, fell from the building and died. We didn't know, like, they didn't prove
okay.
It was whether she was pushed or not.
Okay. So they created the picture that the jury got was that they were engaged in some dangerous activities that led to an accident that was pretty much Chris Archer's fault because he was part of the activities of, you know, her getting really drunk and then suggesting that she go hang up this flag up high, and she tries to do it and falls off. And is that about right, jury?
Yeah.
Okay. Anything? What are things that, let's do some criticisms here, because some of you jurors did this last year, right? Owen did it, all you juniors did. So that's who? That's Owen, Tristan, Mitchell. Yeah. So.
Yeah.
Maddie.
Yeah.
Miss Fuller Camp. So based on your experience doing this same activity and what these guys did, some things that were good, some things that could have been better.
I would say some things that could have been better was just like knowing your part more, like really reading like all the facts of it, you know, and reading, you're getting able to read other people's parts and stuff like that, like just knowing the basis of the case fairly well, like just having a good understanding of what happened, what was your role.
What were things that were good?
I thought the cross-examination was good. I felt like the prosecution's questions.
That was... Yeah, all three of those guys here. Dylan.
Luke did a good job.
Things were pretty well in control. I think, I agree, Luke's, you only have one objection today. That he sustained, and I agreed with it. I thought that was the right call on that objection. He said that the question was, did you think the death was accidental? And we objected based on leading, right? Wasn't that it?
Yeah.
Yeah, I, sure. What could the question have been? That would have been good to do if you could rephrase the question. So instead of, was the death accidental? You want an open-ended question, you could have said, tell me about what happened when Mylan died. Describe the events to me. And then through that testimony, you know, that should come out, that it did it look accidental or not. Okay? Jury, thank you. Head back.
The court of the Second Judicial Circuit for Maryland Division is now in session with the Honorable Judge Rachel Atchison presiding.
You may all be seated. The defense can call up their witness?
Prosecution
can call up their witness.
We recall Dr. Alex Richards.
Will the witness please stand before him?
Please raise your right hand. Please rise to tell the truth, the whole truth, and the truth.
Yes, I do.
Why do you think my man didn't commit suicide?
I think that my Lynn didn't commit suicide because when she was younger, she lost an aunt, her favorite aunt, Tanya, who she looked up to as a role model and loved so dearly. By suicide, she jumped off of a building and she saw that happen.
Why do you think that three shots of alcohol did not affect my niece's brain?
Because my Lynn told me that she was a regular drinker, so I believe that her tolerance would have been a little higher than that.
Can you explain what hazing is?
Hazing is when fraternities or sororities make their pledges do dangerous or humiliating activities or rituals in order to get in.
What motivation do you think Chris Archer had against Hyman?
The motive that
object. Leading.
Sustain. Rephrasing.
I'm done.
You want to try to rephrase your question?
Rephrase it.
Yeah.
Prosecution,
so doctor, why did you first start seeing Mylan?
Because she came to me the first week of orientation.
So she was a perfectionist. Do you think her being a perfectionist has any influence on her being possibly suicidal?
I don't think so.
So you said that she saw her aunt commit suicide. How big of a role do you think that played in her life?
A very big role.
Do you think that she might have been depressed from seeing that and been sad for a while because of seeing that? Because that would have showed her parental role model.
Will the witness please stand to be sworn in by the bailiff?
If they've already been sworn in, they don't have to be sworn in again. Okay, so she does.
Okay, please raise your hand. You swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. Yes.
Tell me what you know about Chris and Mylan's relationship.
I know that Chris at times often seemed like offended by Mylan's personality, and after she refused to go out with another member of the fraternity, it seemed like Chris was out to get her.
How did Chris treat the letters?
He often didn't care like if anybody like caught her, or he wasn't super careful about like what was going on, because people would. Like one time, Pat had an asthma attack and he wouldn't let her have an inhaler.
Where were you when Mylan fell from the tower?
When Mylan fell from the tower, I was running up to the tower to find her. But by the time I got up there, she had already jumped and Chris was the only one close enough to see what actually happened. Defense, do you plan to cross examine?
Do you count Chris a backstabber for being elected president of the GAMA? If he is elected by the people, how would he have been a backstabber?
Because he could have used ways to get around the people, he's a manipulative type of person. So the people
object.
Don't know.
Opinion.
Sustained.
You say Mylan has a drinking problem and has an attitude problem that could easily be mistaken as Seka. What do you really think about her?
Mylan? I think that she was just a part of the Gamma fraternity. She just wanted to succeed and do well and be part of it.
You mentioned having a drinking problem. Has it affected you anywhere else in life?
No, I do not believe it.
What did you suggest to Mylan about trying to do something about her attitude?
I suggested that she try to make new friends and just have a better outlook.
Okay, that's it.
You can just step down. Defense, you want to call up the witness?
I would like to call up Chris Archer to stand.
Will the witness please stand to be sworn in by the bailiff? Please rise, Jerry. Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
Yes.
Mr. Chris Archer, how familiar are you with the Gamma fraternity?
I'm the president of the fraternity. It's the oldest and largest Greek fraternity in the country.
What did you whisper in her ear?
I whispered in her ear before she ran away to Central. I whispered that you're going to have to hang the flag that I intended for her to hang it on her house to scare her a bit for the pledge. And she freaked out, ran towards the center of the town. Ran up the clock tower and tried to hang it.
Did you know Mylan's aunt?
I did not know her aunt.
Did Mylan say anything to you about doing this thing?
She did not. She ripped off her blindfold and ran straight there without telling me.
What do you think about anti-hazing rules and laws?
The dean was very, very strict about it. I knew all the rules. I did not intend for anybody to get hurt.
What do you think about Pat Smith?
I think that Pat Smith is an example of someone who would not want to be held responsible for his actions. That night, he forgot his inhaler, and he just sat quietly while he had an asthma attack, and no one could help him. So we had to rush him to the hospital.
You said on the evening of her death, it seemed she seemed to have a little too much to drink, and she said she knew everyone hated her. What did you say back to her?
I said that no one hates her at all, that she just had too much to drink and that she needs to calm down.
That's all.
Prosecution.
Is it true that the animus started to dislike my name?
That is not true.
You said you do not put your pledges in life-threatening action. But when Patty Smith needed her inhaler, your group would not let her go up to her dorm to retrieve
it. That is false. She just forgot her inhaler, and we didn't know that she was having an asthma attack at the time.
You also said Mylene was drunk, but if she was a frequent drinker, her tolerance level would not affect her. And Patty Smith said Mylene seemed focused.
Had a couple shots to drink, and she just.
You were the first one to catch up with me. What happened on top of
that? She got really close to the edge, saying that she had to raise the flag. I begged her to come back inside, and when she did, she tried to come back in. She stumbled. I tried to catch her, but it was too late.
I called Dean Jesse Thomas to the scene. Please use your right hand. Use your right to tell the truth and not the truth and never have to speak. How familiar are you with the game of fraternity?
I'm very familiar with the fight in the fraternity. It's been around since 1908 and it's an extremely popular organization.
What are your rules about hazing?
We enforce strict campus rules about hazing. We send a letter out to organizations during rush week at the beginning of each year, reminding them of the law and the school rules against hazing.
Have there ever been any reports of hazing incidents?
Sometimes there's been pranks that have been misfired and people get hurt. This is no different from team injuries like sports and suicide.
How well do you know Chris Archer?
I personally know Chris Archer. He's accredited to this university. He and other gamers often volunteer at local places. He plays a huge leadership role. At the campus-wide Greek meeting 2 years ago, he publicly denounced hazing of any kind.
What are your rules about drinking on campus?
The campus administration has also cracked down underage campus drinking. Because alcohol awareness posters all over to inform the students about the danger.
Did you know Mylan's aunt?
I was here when Mylan's aunt attended the university about 6 or 7 years ago. Tanya was president of the Phi Gamma fraternity. It was a real credit to the university. She was certainly a hard act to follow. I would not be surprised if Mylan jumped off the ledge because she did not measure the success of her. That's it.
Prosecution.
How long have you worked as a dean at Oklahoma University?
About 7 years.
Have you ever had any problems with the game before?
No.
What does your school offer opposed to the other schools don't offer as your credibility to the classes and universities?
I'm Jack.
Waiting.
Oh yeah, she's up there.
What does your school offer opposed to the other schools with your classes and your fraternities?
This is like really popular fraternity, and people get more involved with this. They feel like they're more like active.
Did you know that it was Hell Week during the week that Miley died?
Dr. Jordan Mitchell.
May you be sworn in by the bailiff. Please raise your right hand. Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but
the truth? Dr. Jordan, what is Gamma?
Gamma is one of the oldest fraternities that got its start at Columbus University.
What is so great about Gamma?
Gamma is known for its reputation for excellence in high achievement.
Can you give me the relationship between Mylan and Tanya Maddox?
Tanya Maddox is Mylan's paternal aunt.
How did Tanya die?
Tanya committed suicide by jumping off the ledge for nothing.
Did you pay Dr. Alex for information?
I paid Pat Smith $1,000 to get information to use in my book.
That we all.
Cross-examine the witness.
Is it true you have a PhD in American history?
That's true.
How many people have died or been injured during the gamma pledging activities since the start of the games?
Not many people have died. There's just been many injuries.
Is there any circumstances where hazing was obvious in the gamma fraternity?
I don't know.
We would like to recall Tyler Johnson to the stand for cross-examination. Tyler Johnson, during your direct examination, you said that Mylan had jumped from the clock tower. If you're saying that she jumped, do you admit that she was committing suicide?
No, I do not believe that she jumped, and if she did jump, it was because she was told that she had to in order to become part of the games.
That is all.
Can ask any more questions, or are we ready?
Yeah.
I would like to recall Chris Archer to the stand.
Chris Archer, could you please explain your entire story of the night of her accident?
Well, the night started off by doing their activities, and we did not intend them to drink. That was their own choices, and we were doing a thing that we had them blindfolded. We're going to make them do something, and I whispered in her ear. I said, "You're going to have to raise a flag," like I said before, and I intended for it to put up a frat house. So she ripped off her blindfold and ran away towards the center of the campus. She seemed to drink a lot at that party the night, and when she did that, she started crying, saying that everybody doesn't like her, but I tried to tell her that we do, that there's nothing wrong with her. And she ran towards the campus center, and she was very drunk and upset, and so she ran onto the clock tower, and I was the only person that was able to catch up with her. I begged for her to come back inside, as I said before, and she stumbled and fell. And I'm sorry that Mylan died, but I'm not a murderer. She got drunk and chose to go on the ledge without prodding from any other of the Gamma members. So I think Tyler Johnson is testifying because he's jealous that he didn't win president in the election before. And there's no reason for me to haze because I know the strict policy that they didn't set. So there's no point in order to do this.
Why was Mylan upset of the night that she died?
Because she drank far too much.
How much did you have to drink that night?
I did not drink that.
We want to re-cross-examine Dean Thomas.
Okay. Didn't Dr. Alex Richards bring it up to your attention with the gamers?
Yeah.
What did you do to address the case?
Is it true that the Gamma fraternity is known for their dangerous teasing techniques?
That is true.
Did you interview Chris Archer before this case?
I attempted to interview Chris Archer.
What did he have to say?
He told me that he was unwilling to discuss the facts of the case before his trial.
Call Tyler Johnson to the
stand. Did you or did you not suggest something to my about doing something spectacular to impress the gamers to outshine the other pledges?
I did suggest that she did something spectacular to help her win the presidency, but I did not expect for her to do something so extreme, and I by no means suggested that she did that, that she do something so dangerous that could
We want to read cross-examine Chris Archer. Pat Smith says, you pressured the pledges to drink, even though you just said you didn't.
During Hell Week, we would not intend for anybody to drink. That does not mean we are going to kick them out or anything for drinking in that case, but that is their choice. We did not have anything to do with it.
That's the only question.
Where we can cross-examine or no?
Yeah, I will. Just so the jury can get a better idea of the story altogether.
You guys want me to go? Yeah, go ahead. I call Pat Smith.
Good stand.
So Pat, what is your relationship with Miley?
We became friends in third grade, and we've been best friends since then. We kind of grew apart in high school, but we decided to do the college search together.
Do you think that she committed suicide?
No, I don't. I think she was pushed off.
Why not?
Because she was always a bright person, and she didn't really have a reason to. Like, she was always happy leading up, and, I mean, she didn't have a reason to, besides how the family was treated her.
The facts say that she probably did commit suicide. She was drunk, sad, had been seeing a psychiatrist, seen suicide. Why do you still not think that she committed suicide? She's a perfectionist, and that just puts that much more pressure on her on top of everything else.
Because she, granted, she was talking to somebody. Even the doctor says she doesn't think she committed suicide. And she didn't have a reason to. She just got into college.
Do you think the fact that she was in college put a lot of stress with all the debt and all the homework and everything else? You think that played a role in it too?
I think the way the gamma treated her had the most effect on her.
That'll be all.
Now I would like to call Tyler Johnson to the stand.
Okay, so this is for a fight, broad lighted.
Alright. Tyler Johnson, you say that you have a drinking problem. What difficulties has this led to?
None.
That's not what you said. You said it has led to problems with my grades, and some of the gamblers think I have a drinking problem. I can tell right away that Mylan is also a drinker. What do you think about Mylan's drinking habits?
I think they were fine. I don't think it affected her at all.
Well, I guess that would make sense, coming from a drinker. You say that Mylan would often chill in your room and you two would drink together, have personal discussions, and drink a lot. Is this true?
No, we would not drink a lot, especially on school days.
Ready? It was on.
Lies, lies, lies.
Ready for closing statements.
Both of the prosecution and the defense have now rested their case. The attorneys will now present their final arguments. Please remember what the attorneys say is not evidence. However, do listen closely. They are intended to aid you in understanding the case. Prosecution, you may begin.
Our witness, Mary Smith, says she ran out with her blindfold off and saw Chris Archer push Melinda off the tower. Dr. Alex Richards said Chris Archer was threatened by Melinda and there was only one way that he would get her out of his way, and that was death.
Defense, you may proceed with your closing argument.
Where is this? Oh. All right, fellow jurist. You people. If you think about it, there's really no way that Chris Archer could be guilty. Yeah, I mean, they just based their entire closing statement off of said. Someone said something. Well, I don't care what someone said. I can say lies, too. What it comes down to was she had a drinking problem. She had depression. She had issues seeing people commit suicide. In the end, she just got under pressure and jumped.
Members of the jury, you have heard all the testimony concerning this case. It is now up to you to determine the facts. You and you alone are the judges of the facts. Once you decide what facts the evidence proves, you must then apply the law as I give to you to the facts as you find them. Wait, do I even have to read that?
You don't have to keep going. Okay. Just remember what I told you in the hallway. They're going for first degree murder, right? That means the definition of first degree murder is that he actually killed her and it was premeditated. Second degree murder is he killed her, but it wasn't premeditated. And manslaughter is accidental, but he's responsible in some way. Okay, and then there's also the criminal hazing part. So I'm going to take the jury back over to Mrs. Lukman's room. We're going to talk a little bit, let them deliberate and decide. You guys can study the Quizlet things if you need to, or check out the reflection assignment.
Have you reached a verdict? What say you?
On the charge of criminal hazing, we find the defendant guilty. On the charge of murder, we find not guilty, but do find him guilty for manslaughter.
So.